I do murals that celebrate culture and community. Being a public artist, it allows me to participate in conversations that are political or around social issues in a way that I think inspires a different kind of dialogue. For me, it's about making sure that people who feel invisible feel seen and feel proud of who they are, but also helping everyone else stop to see, like, oh, wait a second, that looks like so-and-so in my life. I should maybe pay more attention to what they do and how they contribute to my day-to-day. For this one, more than anything, what I wanted to do was to just showcase them in a way that was respectful and that they felt was like an empowerment piece to them.
I am an essential worker. My job as an elementary manager, I love it. Those that know me know that I put my best foot forward. I get up faithfully every day to make sure I do my job and put 150% into it, because I know if I wouldn't do it, who would? It's good to take care of the community, because when we as a school give back, the community gives back as well.
Realmente, mi trabajo como nani es llevar a cabo el desarrollo de los niños. Realmente sí es preocupante, porque mi trabajo es cuidar a los niños y yo no puedo enfermarme. Que si nosotras, los trabajadores esenciales, como nosotras las nanis, que merecemos ser reconocidos por la sociedad, y realmente lo que deseamos es un salario justo, prestaciones, no discriminación, ya que nuestro trabajo es muy esencial para la sociedad. Realmente es un orgullo representar el muro, ya que yo represento a 2.5 millones de mujeres trabajadoras del hogar en todo Estados Unidos.
In mid-March, when the pandemic hit, all of my cleaning jobs were put on hold. So basically, if I wouldn't have my elderly care part-time job, I would be with no work whatsoever and no income. I'm a single mother, so that makes the work and the struggle even harder, because there is no childcare available at this point for many workers. So it would be nice if the government would issue more financial help, especially for single parents like me, when we can't leave our children at home. It's hard sometimes, you know, very hard, but you have to do what you gotta do. Think positive and just make the best of whatever you can, you know.
I like my job. I like servicing people. I like my customers, my coworkers. Initially, it was pretty stressful. I think I didn't really understand what we were up against and what were some of the risks, and I didn't know if I wanted to be at work. And I didn't know if what I was doing was that important in the scheme of things. So when I go out on my route and there's literally thank you cards and customers who take the time to put signs up for you to read when you get there, you know, you're snapped into reality, like, oh, yeah, I'm understanding the level of appreciation for my service during this time and what it means to them. I don't feel like a hero, but I do feel a little bit more appreciated these days.
What I'm most curious about is the long term, right? Like, that's part of the reason why I do public art, because it presents the opportunity for me to put a piece out that isn't just one day, it's gonna last years and years. So I'm curious, how is this moment that we're living in right now gonna change the way we treat these people and the benefits that we start to give them, or are we gonna continue to keep that away from them, you know? Like, I just hope that some real things start to change.